Welcome, everyone. Today, I will be your host, and my name is Claire. Welcome to Global AirLearning. So we are here to share and learn interesting stuff. We are here to make new friends. And if you want to be the speaker, or if you want, you have something of your own that you'd like to present, like tonight, we have a brand new topic. If you want to be a part of this program, please register as a member on our website. And the link of this website is right there on the screen, on slide. And you can also scan that QR code to join the WeChat group. Today's presentation topic will be Mozart, which is going to be presented by Austin. Now, before we start, we are going to have some of our newer participants introduce ourselves. I'll go first. Again, my name is Claire. I am 14 years old. I'm from California, and it's really sunny here. My favorite pastimes are drawing and reading.
Wonderful. Thank you, Claire. My name is Teacher Tanya, and I have been teaching for over 28 years, but I continue to learn every day, just like all of you. I love making new friends, and I love connecting with old friends. So thanks for joining us tonight. So right now, we're going to have the friends who have jobs tonight introduce themselves.
Hi everyone, my name is Helena and I enjoy drawing, dancing, and reading. Currently, I live in Sammamish, Washington. Also, I go to Endeavor Elementary School and is in fourth grade. In addition, today I'm really excited to present the vocabulary for our topic.
My name is Austin. I live in Vancouver. I'm 8 years old and I'll be the coordinator for today. And some of my hobbies are skiing, skating, swimming, and all the other exercises.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jessica. I am 14 years old. I live in California. Some of my hobbies are baton twirling, piano, ballet, golf, and reading. Today, I'm doing the Kahoot for this session. So nice to meet everyone. Thank you.
And Felix will introduce our admin because just like many Zoom classes, we're having a little technical difficulty with Elvin's microphone.
Yeah, so Elvin's microphone is not working today, but Elvin's 12 years old. He lives in California. Some of his hobbies are reading, coding, typing, and playing basketball. Today, Elvin will be our admin.
Hello, I'm Bing Qing. I'm living in Shanghai. I'm 14 years old. I think I am not good at English, so I enjoy this class to learn more English. And I like sports. I like reading books.
Hello, my name is Annie and I am 9 years old. Some of my hobbies are going outside, playing piano, and playing Chinese checkers.
My name is Rebecca. I am 6 years old. I live in California. Some of my hobbies are playing piano, playing games, and watching TV.
I'm Luke. I am 7.5 years old. Some of my hobbies are playing golf and playing sports.
Wonderful. Now we'll go back to Claire, our host.
Yeah, so those are all really amazing introductions. We are already getting to know each other already on the path to making new friends. So now we are going to finally have our presenter introduce herself. Please go ahead, Austin.
Thank you, Claire. So my name is Austin, as you guys might have known, and I'm eight or 9 years old. I live in California, and some of the things I like to do include chess and piano. And today, I will be your presenter. Now, we can finally get into our presentation. So for the next few while or next few slides, we will be talking about Mozart's life. So I hope you learned something and came out with something new that you learned. I chose this topic because I play the piano and I'm curious about other instruments. Who is this famous person? This somebody is a famous composer of classical period. He composed his first piece of music when he was 5. Who is he?
Maybe Mozart.
Oh, and Alvin guessed Mozart, and Annie guessed Mozart. Any other guesses?
Mozart.
So, for the those of you who guessed Mozart, you are correct. I never really thought that you would know this, but you guys are geniuses and guessed correctly. Now, let's get into Mozart's life, his history, and his music. If someone was a famous person, we cannot continue with the easiest thing in mind to me and should also be for you. When they were born, where they lived, and their accomplishments. Mozart was born on January 27, 1756, and he was born in Salzburg, Austria. He wrote in all the musical genres and excelled in every single one. And lastly, his range of expression in music made him the most universal of all the composers. Now we can get into Mozart's childhood. Mozart started playing the harpsichord when he was only 3 years old, and soon he learned the violin, piano, and way more. This kid was a music prodigy and genius all his life. Mozart made his first music composition, Munet and Trio in G major, when he was only 5 years old. Then he published his music when he was 7 years old. Also, whenever he heard two notes that sounded horrible together, he would cry. And that would only have happened if it was on the day he was born and until he was 3 years old. The music sheet that he wrote is on the left of the slide. Now let's enjoy his music, a Munet and Trio in G major. Mozart had a family grand tour when he was only 8 to 11 years old. Starting at Salzburg, his own town, he worked his way up to London, then back to his own town, or where he was born, Salzburg. The black line shows him and his family going to London, and the red line shows him going back to Salzburg. During his grand tour, he started playing for royal people at that time, and that is something respectful to do to royal people back then. During his travel in London, 8 years old Wolfgang, also known as Mozart, met with a person named Johann Christian Bach, who had a strong influence on him. Bach spent 5 months teaching Mozart in composition, and Bach was described as the only true teacher of Mozart. Mozart still had 30 music compositions survived during the grand tour. Why, you might ask? Well, he made music sheets only on pieces of paper, but as he traveled, some flew away. The works included sonatas, symphonies, and other minor pieces. But this works included sonatas, symphonies, arias, and other minor pieces. Now, let's listen to another Mozart piece. We can get into Mozart's teenage years. 14-year-old Mozart played the harpsichord in Verona, Italy, which is also known as the cradle of the opera. The opera houses in Milan, Vienna, and Naples were all well-renowned in Mozart's time, and only famous works were played, recommended, / acknowledged there. But his life wasn't staying there. His life had more ups and downs you may have had. Mozart's adulthood finally starts now. As Mozart went in Paris exploring and trying to make a benefit for his father, who forced him into a new career. And why benefits? Because almost all the money went to his father. He wanted to be rich. A little while later, his mother died. And Mozart knew if he told his dad, he would blame him. But at one point, Mozart had to tell his father. Mozart left the place and went back to his town, and he told the news to dad, which made him furious. He blamed it on him, obviously, when clearly it wasn't. And he had to stay home until he was 25 years old. He hadn't done much as he sadly stayed home working. Though he was an amazing slash outstanding person, he died only at the age of 35. Just a decade later after he moved out of his parents' home, he died. He died of mercury poisoning, kidney failure, and lastly, scarlet fever. But there are more diseases that came to happen. But still, Mozart is famous for his life struggling just to become an composer. He made lots of things, even with the pressure in his life like this. And here are some interesting facts. Mozart lived in a period called classical period. Music in classical period was orderly, balanced, and clear. Three famous composers in this period are Mozart, Haydn, and Beethoven. Mozart addressed Haydn the term Papa, who is the father of the symphony. Haydn offered Mozart advice. He lent Mozart his personal copy of the famous counterpoint textbook, which was heavily covered with Haydn's personal annotations. On the other hand, Mozart had a powerful influence on Beethoven's works. Beethoven held Mozart in high regard. Some of his music recalls Mozart's work. During Mozart's short life of 35 years, he composed more than 600 pieces of music. He composed in all different musical forms, including operas, symphonies, concertos, and so on. Today, he is widely considered one of the greatest composers in the history of Western music. Now, let's enjoy some of Mozart's music. The symphony number 25 in G minor was written by the 17-year-old Mozart in 1773. Now, let's listen. Symphony No. 40 in G minor was written by Mozart in 1788. Now let's listen carefully again. The piano concerto number 21 in C major was completed on March 1785. Now listen carefully again. Admonis Mozart, his full name, Clarinet Concerto in A major, was written in 1791. Listen carefully again. Now, I know made a lot and buy 600 more, but some are really popular, and this one might be a classic to you. Rondo alla Turca in A major was written in 1783. Popular one, here we go. The Piano Sonata, number 16 in C major, another classic one, but you might not know as well often, was written in 1788. Listen carefully again. Piano Sonata number 10 in C major was composed in 1783. Listen again. Vocabulary time.
So the first word is harpsichord, which is a keyboard instrument with horizontal strings.
Ooh, would a friend like to make a sentence with harpsichord?
A harpsichord is a type of instrument.
I know many instruments, but I only play the harpsichord.
I have never seen or played an actual harpsichord.
Did you know that a harpsichord has two rows of keys? It's not like a piano, because a piano only has one layer of strings, but a harpsichord has two.
The harpsichord was an instrument in the Baroque period.
Wonderful, friends. Let's see what our next word is.
Next word is prodigy, which is a person, especially a young one, has exceptional qualities or abilities, mainly about learning.
Well, I have an app that's called Prodigy, and it's a math app. I always use it.
Yes, we often play Prodigy, and also I am a mathematical prodigy.
A prodigy can be anyone if they only study and work hard. For example, Mozart was a musical prodigy his whole life.
Let's see what our next word is.
We also have the word composition, which is a work of music or art.
When I play the piano sometimes, I make my lyrics, which leads to me making a composition.
Mozart composed many compositions.
I always draw out compositions or even play out compositions.
I've actually made a composition for my school when I was in fifth grade.
I have played many compositions, but I haven't played one composition by Mozart.
Mona Lisa is a beautiful composition by Leonardo da Vinci.
I'm working on a composition, and it's going to be called Sonata in G minor, because currently my piece is in G minor with a B flat. The next word is opera, which is a dramatic work of one or more acts, a set of music for singers and instrumentalists.
Chinese have a Chinese opera, which sing in a very high-pitched voice and takes years of practice.
I actually almost went inside an opera house.
What are instrumentalists?
Oh, instrumentalists are basically people that play instruments. Like, technically, if you play the piano, you're an instrumentalist, but pianos aren't usually part of the like an orchestra, but if you play an instrument, you're still an instrumentalist.
I think it was last year or something, there was this
after the COVID, there was like every year there's some like sort of opera called like the Phantom of the Opera or something. I think it's called the Phantom of the Opera. But like we were not allowed to watch because of course the COVID. So then they put it on YouTube, and then like we watched me and my family watched it on YouTube, and it's pretty good. But there was a lot of singing, but there's also some action.
I've looked at the Nutcracker opera.
Yes, there's so many out there. And when I went to an opera house, the opera house before pandemic, it was so beautiful that that's part of the amazing part also is to visit the opera house. One day we'll be there again. Okay, let's see what our next word is.
Before we start, if you want to hear a little bit about an opera called Madame Butterfly, you can listen to that. Also, cradle's original meaning is crib, but in this presentation, it means a place, process, or event in which something originates or flourishes.
Mesopotamia was the cradle for a Sumerian civilization.
Actually, my baby sister now, she's still 1 year old and she's still in the crib. She was about to get out of the crib, but she now stays in the crib forever.
In addition, we have the word symphony, which is an elaborate musical composition for full orchestra, typically in four movements, and at least one of which is in traditional sonata form.
Many composers, including Beethoven and Mozart, have written symphonies, and I really like listening to their symphonies.
I don't think I have ever been to a live symphony or ever heard a live symphony or heard a symphony at all.
What does orchestra mean?
Ooh, orchestra.
So an orchestra is basically a place, like a group of musicians, and they perform on one song. And it's not just one instrument. There are lots of instruments. And as you see in the picture, there's a conductor, even though it's kind of like blurry, but you see this step that the conductor, and it doesn't face the audience. They face backward because he's supposed to conduct the orchestra. And as you see, you don't just see the violin, also harps and bigger violins, which is the viola or cello, and so on.
Many instruments play in a symphony.
I wonder why Austin always chooses pictures that are in real opera things.
Haydn is actually known for his symphonies. He's also called the father of symphonies as well.
You have the word mercury, which is a heavy silver light metallic chemical element that is liquid at ordinary temperatures.
Mercury is also known as quicksilver, and in the past, it was thought to be an elixir for immortality elixir. But many people who drank it were poisoned to death.
I thought Mercury was a planet's name.
Ooh, Emma, you are correct. It is. Good connection.
Yeah, it has two names, even though they're both called Mercury.
Mercury, this a heavy silvery white poisonous chemical. This Mercury and the planet Mercury both have the same spelling. And Mercury is also kind of weird. I mean, it's the smallest planet and it gets very hot and cold.
Is Mercury like a mirror, sort of?
Ooh, kind of looks like that. Good observation. Let's see what's next.
Question one. What musical instrument would you want to play?
A piano, but I do play piano.
I want to play the violin.
I want to play the piano because I already know how to play the piano.
I want to play the harp because it sounds like it's like kind of calm.
I want to play the piano even though I already play the keyboard.
I know how to play the piano, but I want to learn how to play the cello.
Alvin?
I play many instruments. The piano, guitar, and violin, but I actually really want to play the flute because I think I can hold my breath for a long time.
Oh, cool. And Felix wrote that in the chat. He wants to play it too. And Zemo. So let's go to our next question now, friends. We want to have one more question, then we've got to go to game time.
Question two. Which period of music do you like? Baroque, classical, romantic, or 20th and 21st centuries?
I like the classical period because like Mozart.
Okay, wonderful. Felix?
I like the romantic because, well, first of all, there's some pretty cool people here, like Tchaikovsky. And also, I don't like Baroque because it's sort of like more olden. But then I also, classical is a little bit like more classical. And then the contemporary, like modern days, it's a little bit too modern. So I need some romantic pieces. And romantic sounds pretty good.
I like classical.
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 I like romantic because in that period, the music are more emotional.
I can't choose. I like the Baroque, I like the classical, I like the romantic in the 20th and 21st centuries. But if I had to pick one, I think I'd probably choose something between classical and romantic.
I like the contemporary music.
I like classical and romantic.
All right, so now that we've completed our slides, it's now for game time. Coming to Global Air Learning. Thank you to all the helpers and thank you to Austin, our presenter, for giving this whole presentation about Mozart. I'm very proud of you. And again, thank you everyone for coming. I just want to leave you guys with one last word. If you want to be a presenter, remember to scan the QR code to visit the website. It's ICEA1.org. And we are looking forward to seeing you again. Next week, we're going to have a presentation on natural disasters by Rui Shan. So we can't wait for that too. Okay, thank you all. Thank you all, bye.